Hello everyone, this is Kenny Bruni from Cambrew Tech and welcome back to the channel. So in this series of videos, we are learning Bootstrap version 5. So in this particular video, we are going to look at links and buttons. Pretty much a lot hasn't changed, but then there are some few changes I'd want us to look at. So with a link, let's say we have a link like this. Okay, and let's say we have, like I did, let's say we have contact us. So this is a link. Now, in order to change this into a button, you need to come into the anchor tag and apply a Bootstrap class over here. So the class is btn dash, and we specify the color that we want. Remember, we spoke about the contextual colors. So when I save this, now you can see that we have this contact S in the primary color, which is a blue, and this is a button that we can use. All right, so this is good. Now let's duplicate this and see the other colors. So I'll do a shift alt and a down arrow key, and after primary, definitely we have secondary, then we have info, we have warning, we have success, then danger. These are basically the contextual colors. Then we have light and muted and all that. So all these are the contextual colors, and we are making buttons or links out of them. So this is just one way of doing it, and we can equally make a button. So let's say we have the button class, and inside of this, let's say we have send. So this by default, the button HTML button element. We can also come in here and apply a Bootstrap class. So we can do btn. And when I do success, as you have it this way, now this changes, or this gets styled into a button. So it depends on what you are doing. If you are using a button element, you can style it. If you are using the anchor tag, you can style it. Then also, you can also use the input of type button. So you can do an input of type button, like we have it over here. So the value is going to be the text. And let's say we have delete like this. So this is it, and we can come in here and add in the Bootstrap class btn dash, and let's say we do danger, and this now becomes the delete danger button that we can apply some kind of logic into the back end. Then also, we can also have an input of type submit, and you've seen me do this a number of times. So input of type submit, and let's say we have send over here. And all that we need to do to style this is to come in here and apply the btn dash. Let's do info, and this is with buttons. So this is the ones that we know. We can further on modify things, and remember, we also have the dark contextual color, so we can use all the contextual colors to style our buttons. Good. And the also have some hovering effects around them. When you hover around it, you see some hovering effects on the buttons. Now what I want to show is, previously for the Bootstrap version 4, when I do, and let me use a link tag for example, and let me just put up a brick tag over here. So you have this brick tag over here, and let me save this, and let's have this link tag, and let's say we have this over here, connect. Okay, let me add another brick tag so that it comes down. All right, so here we are. So what I want to do is, I want to start this, and let me add a Bootstrap class, and I'll do btn dash info. Let me do primary over here. And this is nothing different from what we have over here. But in other versions of Bootstrap, I could have done a btn dash block. And this would have stretched this button onto the viewport of what I have over here. Now, btn dash block has been taken out. So in order to get that, and let me show you quickly. In order to get that, all that we need to do is to put in another class over here. So we need to have a div tag, and what I'm going to do is, I'm going to cut this. So I'll do a control X and put it inside of this div tag. And once I save this, nothing has changed. But what we can now do over here is we can put in a Bootstrap class over here. And all that we need to do is we can do a D grade. So when we do a D grade, you can see that this has now stretched. Okay, so the BTN dash block has now changed to a D grade. And we need to put this as a parent class onto this. Okay, now what you are going to see is if I'm to duplicate this, okay. And let's say I have this. Now you can see that there's no space in between these two buttons over here. What I can now do is I can now put in a gap over here. So when I do a gap of, let's say, 1, you can see that there's some level of separation. When I do a gap of 2, it increases. When I do a gap of 3, so it depends on the level of gap that you want. Okay, so a gap of 4, 5, it goes on, and I think 6. Okay, so it ends with 5. Okay, it ends with 5. So a gap of 5 will give you this. All right, so let's maintain a gap of 3. And this is with the display block. This is how it looks now. All right, now let's look at the other button styles. So let's do a break tag. Let me have 2 of them over here. And let's have a link tag over here. And let's see, I have another connect over here. So this is it. And what I want is I can do a btn dash. Let's say I'll do outline dash info. So what this outline dash info does is, yes, we want the info styling, but we added an outline class over here, or an extension to it over here, so that there's only the outline, and this looks pretty much very nice over here. So let me just duplicate this. I'll do a shift alt and the down arrow key, and in place of info I can add in a dark to get the dark color, as you can see over here. I can add in the danger, I can do warning, I can do success, and it can go on and on. So these are the other contextual colors and styling of buttons. And trust me, if you are heavy on CSS, you realize that this saves you a lot of time. Okay, all that you need to do is to know the Bootstrap class. But please remember that we first of all need to prefix it with a BTN, then the BTN dash outline dash info. That's if you want to have this neatly styled buttons over here. You can also do same with the input tags, or let's say the button HTML element. And let's say we have save over here as a text. So I can do a class of btn dash outline dash, and let's do success over here. Okay, and we have the same thing. Okay, so before we end this particular section, one of the things I would also want to touch on is, let me also bring out a break tag over here. And let's also have a link or an anchor tag over here. And this time around, let's see, we have press showing up over here. So let's have a class. Let's do btn. Then we have info like this. Okay, this is the info class. Now we can add in another extension of this class to change some few things over here. And this is what I mean. We can maintain this first one, and let's say we have a btn-sm. So remember when we were dealing with, I think, yeah, with these line height properties, we're having the line height sm, line height lg, okay? And that's with the level of consistency we have over here. When we do btn-sm, now we are going to have this button to be small as compared to the other ones. And we can do a btn-lg, and this is now going to be big. Okay, so there's some level of consistency where all the sm extensions will make whatever we are applying it on to become small, and the lg is going to become big. Now it's definitely going to work with the other variations as well. So we can do, let's say, info outline And now we have LG over here. So as you can see, this is now the info outline LG. And we can also do, let's say, danger outline, and let's do SM. Okay. Okay, so it's supposed to be outline danger. So as you can see, it is having some issues over here. So it's supposed to be outline dash danger. The outline comes before the color. Okay, and that's what we have over here. So we can mix things up so far as it makes sense. And it doesn't really matter which class comes first. Okay, so let me show you this. Let's say we have this, and let's say we have save over here. Let me just put up a break tag over here so that things will look nice. And let's say we have a class. It doesn't matter which comes first. Okay, so we can do a btn-info. We need to bring the btn once again, and it is going to work as it is. Okay, it doesn't matter whether btn comes first or now. Actually, what this btn class primarily does is this: actually styling it. The btn-info is just styling it, as you have over here, and the btn will now make it a button. Okay, and we can now bring, let's see, the btn-sm in order to make it small. Okay, so it doesn't matter which really comes first, but I think for the sake of consistency, it's always good to start with btn, then your btn dash your color. Okay, so you bring in your danger, then let's say your btn dash lg. Okay, it kind of makes sense so that it follows some chronological order, because you have your btn. Okay, so first of all, you want to make it a button, then you want to apply the color, then you want to apply the size, then if you want to apply more styling onto the button, then we can come inside of it and come and apply the outline over here. All right, so this is going to be the end of this video. Now I believe you are enjoying this, and trust me, by the end of this series, we are definitely going to get comfortable working with Bootstrap. Now, if you find this tutorial very interesting, there are a couple of ways you can help me grow my channel. Kindly subscribe to Cambrotech, and don't forget to hit on the notification button so that anytime I release a video, you'll be duly notified. Also, share this video with friends and family who find this content very useful. At Cambrotech, we say learn programming. You can do it. Bye-bye.